Welcome back to Upfront. The September primary is 205 days away, but the first television ads of the 2010 campaign are already hitting the airwaves. Republican gubernatorial candidate Mark Newman launches his first ad tomorrow. Take a look.
Mark Newman, a businessman ready to lead. A husband, father, and grandfather who started by working his way through college, then taught school and coached. Mark Newman and his wife started a business in their basement, which today provides hundreds of jobs.
In a statement to Upfront, Newman said his ad is one way for him to share his vision for the future of this great state and highlight his ability to help rebuild Wisconsin from a period of economic turmoil and fiscal mismanagement. Republican U.S. Senate candidate Terrence Wall recently began running his first TV ad.
After 28 years in politics, Russ Feingold isn't listening anymore.
This bill is being shoved down our throats, backroom deals, without transparency. We are fed up, and you better get your resume ready.
We need a new kind of leader, Terrence Wall.
So, with the primary election months away, what is the strategy behind these early ads? Today we're asking Ken Goldstein, the UW-Madison political science professor who studies political advertising. He's at our Madison affiliate, WKOW-TV. Professor Goldstein, good to see you again. You could make the argument that it's late February and that most people really aren't focused on these fall campaigns yet. Yet you're something of a fan of these early ads.
Yeah, I mean, it obviously is very early, but I've often been a proponent of early advertising. Politics is sort of this weird business where campaigns end up spending most of their money when people have already decided what product to buy and when everyone else is advertising as well. So you end up getting, and I'm sure we'll still see it here, intense amounts of advertising from both sides as election day nears. But the fact of the matter is, most people have made up their mind close to election day, plus everyone else is advertising, so it's hard to get your message out. And for Mark Newman, who needs to reintroduce himself to the voters of Wisconsin, the ability to reintroduce himself to voters when there's no other clutter, I think is a chance he had to take and an investment that he had to make.
That is an interesting point you raise. It really is an introduction or a reintroduction of Mark Newman, who once ran for the U.S. Senate and came very close to knocking off Russ Feingold, who was a congressman from southeastern Wisconsin. People have short memories in politics, don't they?
I mean, for those of us in politics, we remember that as a titanic Senate race in the state.
Sure.
But that was 12 years ago. And you look at polling in the gubernatorial race, and 50% of Wisconsinites don't know, 50% even of Republican primary voters don't know who Mark Newman is. They also, a fair amount of people also don't know who Scott Walker is. So although Walker's still clearly in the lead, I think, there's lots of people who don't know either candidate.
That's sort of a nice, warm, fuzzy ad. Mark Newman, job creator, very positive ad, which leads me to the first Terrence Wall ad in the race against Russ Feingold this year. That's a much tougher ad, an ad that takes on Feingold directly, but also introduces you to Terrence Wall. Are you surprised at that for a first ad?
I am. Listen, it's a classic contrast ad where you have these jarring negative images in the first 15 seconds, and then it turns soft and color and introductory in the last 15 seconds. That campaign at some point will get negative, and T. Wall is going to have to try and make an argument against Russ Feingold. But usually campaigns try and give people a little sorbet to cleanse their palate before they start the negative advertising. And nobody knows who Terrence Wall is. And to come right out of the chute with a negative ad is not consistent with what most people in politics would do. Most people would lay down an introduction of themselves before they try and turn and try and define or portray the other candidate.
Is this the year of the hard hat for political commercials? We see the first two ads, they're both wearing hard hats.
It absolutely seems to be the year of the hard hat. Both candidates are wearing a hard hat. But you see that clearly the focus is going to be on jobs in this campaign. Campaigns can be about lots of things, but as the Obama administration has learned, as everyone in Washington has learned, as campaigns have learned, there's going to be one thing that any competent candidate in this state talks about. It's jobs, jobs, jobs. And I always say, advertising is also, for you poker players out there, a tell. You don't need to be looking at the polling. You can tell what's going on with the advertising. And you have two candidates who need to introduce themselves, and you clearly have one major concern, and that concern is jobs, period.
Let's talk about political advertising on television during this campaign. That's always been the way to reach the largest number of folks out there. But now you're seeing more and more ads targeted toward the web, YouTube. You're getting information in a different way. Are TV ads still the best way to get your message out in a political campaign?
You know, it's funny. I've been studying this for a number of years, and in the odd year, I'll always get a call calls from a bunch of reporters who say, this is not going to be the year when there's lots of TV advertising, right? It's going to be the year of robocalls or the year of direct mail or the year of the Internet. And then I usually get a call a couple months later asking me to comment on the record-breaking level of TV advertising. So the Internet is a tool mostly to communicate with people who already agree with you. So those ads that people are seeing on YouTube or seeing on a campaign's website, those typically aren't undecided voters. Mm-hmm. Those typically aren't people who don't know anything about you. Internet is important as an organizational tool, but I think we're still in a world where candidates are going to raise money on the Internet and spend it on local television stations.
Well, to quote an old song, we've only just begun. So we will be talking to you throughout this campaign. UW-Madison political science professor Ken Goldstein, always great to have you on the show. Thanks again for being with us.
Thanks for having me.
And next week on Upfront, I'll have an interview with Republican gubernatorial candidate and Milwaukee County executive Scott Walker. I hope you'll join us then.